Hello, welcome back to my channel, Charlie's Lessons, and in this video, we're looking at a tool that can make quizzes for your students in seconds. So today we're looking at an AI tool. If you are interested in incorporating artificial intelligence into your classroom, then go check out my playlist right here that looks at how we can use AI in the classroom. So the name of the tool we're looking at today is called Conker, and we can access it by visiting conker.ai. So once we're at the website, the first thing we see is how we make a quiz. There are four things we can change. So we can change what type of quiz it is, how many questions there are, what age the students are, and also what is the topic of the quiz. There's also a second option on how to make quizzes, which is using a text. So you just need to give it a title and then paste in the text you would like to make the quiz about. We can also change the type of quiz from multiple choice to mixed. Today we're going to be focusing on this type of quiz, which you can see before us now. So let's do an example right now. I'm going to decide to do a multiple choice quiz with 5 questions. I'm going to make it a bit older, so 6th grade, and I'm going to make it about wild animals. And I'm going to go to generate. And in just under a minute or so, here we have our quiz. And we can see here that we've got our 5 questions, each multiple choice, and we can see the answer is marked. We can also validate the answer with Google search. So if I don't believe that a dog is a wild animal, I can validate the answer by clicking here, and it's going to give me some further information about why a dog is not a wild animal. Now, this can be useful both for the teacher and for the students. Now that we have our quiz ready, we've got a couple of options on how we can share it with our students. The first one is to share a link with our students so they can do it on their mobile phones. Another option is to export it to Google Forms, and we're going to look at that in a moment. Also, we can print the quiz either as a PDF or on paper, so you can use it in class with your students. Another option that I like to use is to print it as a PDF, but then just present that in the class for our students to answer as a group together with the teacher. If your students do have mobile phones in your classroom and you want to make use of them, then you can use the share link option. If in your classroom your students don't have mobile phones, or maybe you're not allowed to use mobile phones, then go check out this feature on quizzes right here, which allows students to take part in a quiz without mobile phones. So to get set up with sharing the link with our students, we just go to assign or export in the top right hand corner, and we just go to copy shared link. Click this, and now this needs to be shared with your students. So here we're looking at it from the student's perspective, and the code is actually in the link, so they don't need to add that. I'm just going to continue, and I just need to add their name. So we're going to put Pedro, and Pedro is going to join the quiz, and you can see here are the questions. So Pedro is now going to answer this. Okay, so Pedro has just finished the quiz, and he can see in front of him how many questions he got right and how many he got wrong. And, you know, he got about 40%, which is to be expected of Pedro, to be honest. From the teacher's perspective, if we just go to activity on the left-hand side, we've now got a list of results from previous quizzes. And the quiz that we've just done now is called Wild Animals. And I'm going to go to View Results. And here we can see Pedro. I'm going to click on View Breakdown. And as the teacher, I can also see what Pedro saw at the end of his quiz. I can see which questions he got right and which questions he got wrong. If we had more students participating, then I just need to click on these little 2 arrow keys here, and I could switch between various students. The next option we're going to look at is how we export this to Google Forms. So to do this, again, we go to Assign and Export in the top right hand corner, and we just click on Export to Google Forms. Here we have the exact same test, but in Google Form format. And let's just check it has the answers already in there too. So let's see, click on one question, go to answer key, and yes, it has already marked the correct answers, and it's given us some feedback to use with our students as well. Now, why would you use Google Forms instead of Conker's own website? Well, there's a couple of benefits. You can get to export the responses to a spreadsheet on Google Forms just by clicking on responses and then link to sheets. And when you start receiving responses on Google Forms, you can start to view the data in a nice visual way. So you can see these graphs and also sometimes bar charts. And this is just a nice way of viewing the results of your students. And this is not provided on Conker. The next way and the more basic way of using Conker is to go to print question sheet. just by going to here. Now, what this is obviously going to do is set you up with a print option, so you can go to either save as PDF, or if you have a printer, which I don't at the moment, you can select your printer here and just print the amount of copies that you need for your class. You can also print the answer sheet, so the students can check their answers after they're done. Another option that I like is to save it as a PDF and just present this to your class, either on your projector in your classroom or on a TV, and get your students to use their notebooks and write their answers there. This saves you having to get their phones out, and it also means you save a bit of paper as well. Now, if you'd like to get some inspiration from the community and perhaps you're not really sure about how to create the test yourself, we just go to explore on the left-hand side and we can search by the subject for some tests or some examples of tests that you could use straight away in your classroom. So let's have a look at perhaps world history, and we have a test here on important turning points from the year 600 to 1450. And we can have a little read through and think, okay, I think I could use this in my classroom. And we just go to make a copy in the top right. And now this has become ours, and we can assign this with our students or export it as a PDF. One thing I do want to mention about Conker and about testing in general, remember Conker is creating very generic tests. If you are going to maybe test your students on a unit in the coursebook, or maybe test their knowledge after a term or after a year, it's better that you as the teacher design the test yourself. That way you can include the content that you've been studying. Do not rely on Conker for tests like these. I personally use Conker at the beginning of a class just to get an idea about what my students may or may not know about a certain topic. Thank you for watching this video on another AI tool that could save teachers a lot of time. I'll see you in the next video.